Among the expected topics during Biden and Xi's meeting is North Korea. On the eve of the crucial talks, Biden said the U.S., along with Japan and South Korea, have agreed to take resolute steps towards the complete denuclearization of North Korea. Tensions at the Korean Peninsula have escalated recently over the North's flurry of missile tests. The three countries are condemning those moves, calling the tests a grave threat to peace and security in the region.
Japan and the Republic of Korea are both critical allies of the United States, and for years our countries have been engaged in trilateral cooperation out of a shared concern for the nuclear and missile threats that North Korea poses to our people. And North Korea continues provocation to rocket behavior. This partnership is even more important than it's ever been.
The leaders of the U.S., Japan, and South Korea met on the sidelines of the ASEAN summit in Cambodia. All eyes in Bali, Indonesia, for the highly anticipated meeting between the leaders of the world's largest economies. U.S. President Joe Biden and his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping will meet in person this afternoon for the first time since the American leader took office. But expectations are low for the high-stakes talks. U.S. officials hope, though, Biden can build the foundation for a functional relationship that doesn't tip over into conflict.
I know I'm coming in stronger, but I don't need that. I know Xi Jinping. I spent more time with any other world leader. I know him well. He knows me. There's no, we have very little misunderstanding. We just got to figure out where the red lines are and what are the most important things to each of us going into the next 2 years. And his circumstances changed, to state the obvious, at home. And so we're going to have, I think, I've always had straightforward discussion. There's never any miscalculation about what each of us stands. I think that's critically important in our relationship.
Biden returned to the White House with ties between Washington and Beijing in their worst shape in decades as tensions flare across trade, technology, and geopolitics. Xi is heading to the meeting as the strongest Chinese leader since Mao Zedong, while Biden is coming on the heels of a major victory for Democrats in the U.S. midterm polls. Now, speaking of the ASEAN summit, Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is back in the country following his trip to Cambodia. Marcos, along with several cabinet members and other delegates, landed in Manila past midnight. Marcos described his participation in the summits as very successful. He said he was able to articulate the country's interests and commitment to working with ASEAN and dialogue partners.
We also got the opportunity to put forward our position, our plans, and to find ways where we can help each other, where we can coordinate, and all that. I think it was quite gratifying to see that there was a very large area of consensus amongst the ASEAN member states. Ganun pare-pareho kasi sa atin yung food supply, presyo ng fertilizer, presyo ng langis, yun ang inaalalas.
But Marcos said no progress was made on a code of conduct on the South China Sea. Marcos was among the ASEAN leaders who had pressed on the matter during his interventions in the ASEAN-China Summit and ASEAN East Asia Summit.
It is urgent. It is becoming more and more urgent. And we really should, the negotiations and the finalization of the code of conduct. There's been some progress in the past year, but we really need to have the actual code of conduct already finalized and already in place as soon as possible. Everybody, including the Chinese, says we follow UNCLOS and the international law. So at least that position of ASEAN is clear.
The Philippines and many other nations have repeatedly called on China to adhere to the 2002 Declaration on the Conduct of Parties in the South China Sea, which states that they exercise self-restraint in the conduct of activities that would complicate or escalate disputes and affect the stability in the region.